Wisdom of Solomon chapter 3 verse 9, and it reads, "They that put their trust in him shall understand the truth, and such as be faithful in love shall abide with him. For grace and mercy is to his saints, and he have care for his elect." First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash, next double honors to the head apostles slash elder bishops of Great Millstone, the one that taught us the 100% truth according to the Bible. Peace, blessings, and safety to all you sincere Ikems. Keep pushing, keep believing, keep their faith, regardless of people here for a bit. His elect. His elect. Let's get the definition. He cares for his elect. It's all about the elect on this side. The elect of the nation of Israel, which consists of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Can we play it?
Elect.
Elect. Let's see. Look, chosen. Chosen. You see it right there? Chosen. It's singled out. The elite. The elite. The favored. The creme de la creme. People who are chosen or singled out. That's the elect of the nation of Israel, which consists of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And we're just reading the script. It's not all about the whole nation right now. You got Israelite groups, so we're here to gather the nation. No, the Lord is gathering the elect. The Lord is gathering the elect, the creme de la creme, the chosen within the chosen. Because you got a chosen nation. The chosen nation, the Lord's favorite nation that he created, is the children of Israel. But within that, you have a chosen. You have an elect. I just read it. The favored. The selected. Everything is predestined already. Before the earth was even formed. An elect group of the nation of Israel was already predetermined. You see? Pre-selected. The chosen, the little A-list, of a person chosen or singled out, put in power, picked, selected. You see it. You see it, elect. So let's go back. And the Lord said the remnant shall return. The elect shall return. Lord willing, we'll have to get that too. But yeah, this lesson is basically just going into how it's all about the elect right now, not the whole nation of Israel. We're not here to gather the community. The Lord ain't even gathering the community. You see? The scriptures tell you the elect will be gathered through this word. Let's get this again. Wisdom of Solomon chapter 3 verse 9. It's all about the elect right about now. And Lord willing, we're part of that hopeful number. That's why we call ourselves the hopeful elect. And the scriptures say, put on therefore as the elect. It's certain characteristics that the elect of the nation of Israel are going to have. And as a matter of fact, I might have to get that. Matter of fact, let's get it now. Let's get it now. Let's get it now. And we're going to come right back. Bear with me. Colossians chapter 3. We'll start at verse 12, and it reads, "Put on therefore as the elect." You heard how to hear no other Israelite groups talking about you. You most definitely ain't gonna hear it in these plantation churches. Plantation Christianity, you're not gonna hear nothing about the elect if they're talking about everybody, everybody, everybody. The scriptures don't talk about everybody. Put on therefore as the elect. Because remember, I mentioned the elect has certain characteristics. Right? There's certain characteristics about the elect. And here's some of them too. Put on therefore as the elect of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, holy, separate, right? And beloved, bowels of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind. You look, you're not proud, you're meek. That proud, you know what I'm saying, pompous, arrogant spirit that you see going on among the children of Israel, that's not putting on, that's not a characteristic the elect would have. That proud spirit, the hopeful elect ain't walking around like they proud. You see? they're humble. Because that's what the Lord said, he resists the proud anyway, and the meek shall inherit the earth, right? Humbleness of mind. They're not thinking too highly of themselves, right? Meekness, humbleness, lowliness, long-suffering, forbearing one another. These are all the characteristics of the elect, right? And forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Yahweh Shai forgave you, so also do ye. Characteristics of an elect of the nation of Israel, right? And above all these things, and above all the things that I just named, of the characteristics an elect would have, and above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. So these are all the characteristics. Do you see this coming from the average Israelite group? Do you see meekness? Do you see bowels of mercy? Do you see kindness? Or do you see long suffering? Do you see proud, arrogant, pompous spirits? See, holy in thou spirits. That's what you see coming from the majority of these other Israelite groups. They're not putting on, therefore, as the elect of the nation of Israel. They got the characteristics of a two-third of a damn ninja. That's why blessed is he that readeth, right? It says, and let the peace of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai rule in your hearts, meaning in your minds, to the which also ye are called in one body. The elect, they're the true one body, you see? And be ye thankful. Oh, yeah. Let the word of Yahweh Shai dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Yahweh Shai. Remember to see how important those names is. This is what the elect was going to be. These are characteristics of the elect, right? What it say? And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Yahweh Shai, Hamashiach, giving thanks to the Heavenly Father Yahweh and the Father by him. These are all the characteristics of the elect of the nation of Israel. It didn't say nothing about pride. It didn't say nothing about arrogance. It didn't say nothing about exalting yourself. Those are not characteristics of the elect of the nation of Israel. Just know that. Just know that. So let's go right back. I want to go right back because this lesson is all about the elect. No doubt about it. Let's go right back. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 9. I just want to bring out those characteristics. You see? Just went through all the majority of the characteristics, you know what I'm saying? Pretty much all of them, pretty much named all of them, of an elect of the nation of Israel. Lord willing, we part of that whole number, right? But you see, among these other Israelite groups is pridefulness, is boasting, is bragging. It's everything that 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter, went into. Lovers of pleasures, more than lovers of the Heavenly Father, covetous, braggers, boasters, disobedient to parents. That's not the characteristics of an elect of the nation of Israel. We just went through the little no charity. Of course, you're not going to have charity when it's all about me, 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 me. Now go back through that Colossians that I just read, Colossians the 3rd chapter, and see if any of those characteristics fit yourself. That's all you got to do. Then you could very well be part of the elect of the nation of Israel. Lord willing, we're part of that hopeful number. But if you ain't got none of those characteristics, don't consider yourself in a hopeful elect. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 9. They that put their trust, aka their faith in him, which is going to be the elect anyway. The elect of the nation of Israel is going to trust heartily. And Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, they that put their trust in him shall understand the truth. The majority of our people, they don't know it. They don't understand the truth. They really don't even know what they're involved in. But the hopeful elect, I'm saying, they're going to put their trust in the Lord, and they're going to understand the truth, the 100% truth according to the Bible. They're going to truly know what they're involved in too. And such as be faithful, they got that word faith again. Remember, they called us over here Great Millstone Faith-Based Israelites. Didn't even know that that was a compliment. Didn't even consider, was too busy trying to scoff and mock and make fun of us. Didn't even know that there was a big up, pretty much. There was a compliment. And such as be faithful in love shall abide with him. For grace and mercy is to the saints, which represents the Israelites, but the Lord gonna always go a little bit deeper, right? And he have care for his elect. Who does the Lord care about right now? His elect, the best of his kind, the chosen, the picked out ones, the best to rule, the aristocrats, the best to rule, man. And who else would be best to rule the earth other than the ones that help create the earth and everything in it? When you think they would be the best to help rule, to help establish order, you know what I'm saying, upon the face of the earth? Come on now. Let's see what else. Matter of fact, let's go here. Let's just go here. The elect, man. I want to go here. Let's see. Let's go to St. Matthew right quick. The 24th chapter. St. Matthew chapter 24. Just something quick too. Lord, had you made just think about it, the elect. We always think about it, the elect, the chosen, the best of his kind, the chosen within the chosen. St. Matthew chapter 24. And whoever don't like it, you got to take that up with the Lord. This is St. Matthew chapter 24. Let's see. St. Matthew chapter 24. Let's see. We'll go straight to the point 30. Then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man. And remember what we read in Colossians, the third chapter, the characteristics of an elect would be calling on the name of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. They were calling on their power. They wouldn't say they ain't got the name. And an elect member of the nation of Israel is not going to be walking around talking about they don't know the name of their power. That don't make no sense. That don't make no sense. Matter of fact, before I even finish that, let's just get, because I got to prove to you, every time I say something, we back it up with scriptures. Over here, Great Millstone, starting off with the Elder Apostles / Elder Bishops of Great Millstone. Every time we say something, you know we back it up with a scripture. You know that. We ain't over here winging it. I want to get this to show you the importance of the name and what it means to the hopeful elect of the nation of Israel. Look, no name, no salvation. I don't know if you got the message. I don't know if you got the memo. I don't know if somebody done told you or not. But no name, no deliverance. Y'all making it about the name. Y'all always making it about the name. You damn right. You damn right we making it about the name. The proper name too. In the Hebrew tongue of the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. You see? What Charles Barkley say years ago, anything else is uncivilized. Sirach, also known as Ecclesiastes, chapter 17, verse 10, and it reads, and the elect, because that's what this lesson is all about, and the elect shall praise his holy name. That separate name, the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Remember, we are the biblical Hebrew Israelites, right? So most definitely, our power name is not in Greek, it's not in Latin, it's not in English, it's in Hebrew. And the elect shall praise his holy name, period, period. And that's the characteristics of the elect of the nation of Israel. They're not going to say, we don't know the name. We're going to get it in the kingdom. When the scriptures say we're going to get it in the land of our captivity. Let that make sense. That's why it's all about the elect. Remember, Lord Yahweh, I said, look, I pray for them. I pray not for the world. Who is it them that he's talking about? The elect of the nation of Israel, which consists of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. You got the 144,000. prophets, elect men, the prophets, and the multitude of believers, which consists of men, women, children. You see, St. Matthew chapter 24, let's go back here. St. Matthew chapter 24, verse 30 again. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man, Lord Yahweh Shai, who they will call Jesus, in heaven. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds, in the chariots of heaven, with the eagerly called UFOs, spaceships, with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect, the chosen, from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. So who is the Lord coming back to deliver? The elect. You can have chariots throughout the four corners of the earth beaming up elect men and elect women and their offsprings throughout the four corners of the earth. The Lord ain't coming back delivering every Israelite on this go around like ancient Egypt. All Israel got delivered out of ancient Egypt. And then soon we got in the wilderness, the Lord purged out the rebels. You see? And the elect of the nation of Israel went into the promised land. You see? Same thing this time. The Lord ain't changing. Same thing this time, man. I want to read 30 again. And look, St. Matthew 24:30, red letter. This is the Lord speaking. What it would say, we ought to obey the Heavenly Father rather than man. This is the Lord speaking. And Yahweh Shai, he saves, he delivers, not no damn Jesus, all right? And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect, man. You see it right there, his elect. You see it, man. From the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. And I quoted, that's what the Lord said, set a mark upon the forehead, Ezekiel. He told Ezekiel in the book of Ezekiel to the angel with the writer's ink horn, set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. And to the others, he said in my hearing, go ye after them through the cities, I'm thinking, and smite, let not your eyes spare. And said the other angels, go after the Israelites that don't have that thawah, that mark of exemption. You see? And straight up delete them. It says, slay utterly old and young. If the Lord was all about loving everybody and gathering all Israel, why would he tell the other angels, you know what I'm saying, those deaf angels, to go through the city and smite, slay utterly old and young, both maids, little offspring, and women? Why is that written if the Lord loves everybody? And I want to get this too. It's all about the elect. And Lord, when are we part of that hopeful number? Lord's will. Remember what I read earlier in Colossians 3? Put on therefore as the elect. Those different characteristics, man. You see? Meekness, bowels of mercy, humbleness of spirit, humbleness of mind. You ain't walking around being prideful, arrogant. You see? You're not being high-minded. You're not exalting yourself. You're not thinking too highly of yourself. You just keep staying low. Staying low. St. John chapter 17. Matter of fact, we read 6 first. St. John chapter 17, verse 6. I'm a little bit excited. I have manifested. The word manifest means to make known, make clear. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world, the elect. Lord Yahweh Shai revealed the name of the Heavenly Father to the elect men of the nation of Israel. I'm reading it right here. Starting first and foremost with the disciples, later known as the apostles, and so forth and so on, right? I have manifested Lord Yahweh Shai, who they even called Jesus, said, look, I manifest the name of the Heavenly Father to the men. So how the hell can a man on earth tell you, walk around telling you in 2024, I call it 3024, tell you that we don't got the name when Lord Yahweh Shai is right here saying he gave us the name? He gave the men that walked with him the name, and those men gave us the name. That's how I went. And that's how it's going now. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were. We can't ignore this scripture right here. The name has been revealed to us. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Remember earlier we read in Wisdom of Solomon 3 and 9? You see? That those that put their trust in him shall understand the truth. The same men back. It's the same men back. Ain't nothing changed. And they have kept thy word. Let's jump down. Verse 9. St. John chapter 17, verse 9. I pray for them. I pray not for the world. You look in the definition for that word right there in the Greek. It's cosmos, a separate society, a godly arrangement. The Israelites. Lord Yahweh, I say, Lord, I pray for them. Who is the them that he's talking about? The elect. The elect. I pray not for the world. So he ain't praying for the majority of the Israelites. Hell, it's shit. You know, what is it? In Jeremiah, the 11th chapter, verse 14, the Lord told us, don't even pray. The Lord said, pray not thou for this people, neither lift up a cry. It's talking about the Israelites. The majority of the Israelites, we ain't praying for you. The Lord commanded us not to. I pray for them, I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, the elect, for they are thine. And the Lord said, I ain't lose one. I ain't lose one. Let's get one more, and I'm going to wrap it up. Let's get one more. Remember what the scripture said? Put on therefore as the elect, right? It's many scriptures. I got all kinds of scriptures through the spirit of Yahweh, by Shemuel Shai, that I could pull out. I want to get this, though. St. Luke chapter 18, right? St. Luke chapter 18. St. Luke chapter 18, verse 7, it reads, and shall not the heavenly Father Yahweh avenge his own elect? His own elect, which cry day and night unto him. Remember, set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof, right? Which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily, fast. That's why time didn't speed it up already. We was talking about it yesterday on the highways and byways, how time is going by fast, man. It's September the 15th right now already. We almost pretty much in the middle part of September. 15, 16 more days, it'd be another month. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, Lord Yahweh Shai, who they're going to call Jesus, shall he find faith on the earth? Yes, because scripture say, let my prophets be found faithful. So the true prophets of the Lord, Lord willing, we part of that hopeful number, are going to be found faithful, right? Let's see what else. Let's see. It's so many scriptures that I can get, man. Bear with me. Ezekiel chapter 14, verse 22, and it reads, yet behold, therein shall be left a remnant, a small number, the elect, right? Yet behold, therein shall be left a remnant that shall be brought forth, both sons and daughters. Let you know the elect consists of men, women, and children, right? Both sons and daughters, behold, they shall come forth unto you, and ye shall see their way and their doings, and ye shall be comforted concerning the evil that I have brought upon Jerusalem, a people before us a place, letting you know that it's talking about the Israelites, even concerning all that I have brought upon it, man. So that remnant is going to turn back to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, and get saved and delivered. You see? And the elect consists of men, women, and children, sons and daughters. All right? Starting off with the 144,000 elect men, the prophets, the teachers, and the multitude of believers, which consists of men, women, and children. Y'all just want to do something quick, man. Won't meant to be nothing long. As soon as I woke up, the Lord was like, the elect. Well, even before I even woke up, you know what I'm saying? Before I even went to sleep last night, the elect, the elect, the elect, the elect. That remnant. That's all I kept hearing. So the Lord had me write down some scriptures, and the Lord willing, the hopeful elect of the nation of Israel, once again, which consists of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, are edified. The Lord is coming to gather the elect. I read it already. The elect. Shalom.